Welcome, everybody, to day three of the BRSO Discovery Concert Series. We're so glad you could join us this morning. And today, behind me, we've got a brass trio. So far, over the course of 3 days, we've gotten to meet the string family and the woodwind family. And now we're going to get to meet the brass family. Although, you know, we're missing maybe at least one instrument from the brass family. But let's start over here on this side, meeting the trombone. Now, you've probably seen all of these instruments. Most of the time, maybe you've seen them in a marching band, maybe. But they also go right into the orchestra and blend with the strings and the woodwinds just as well. Now, the trombone is pretty unique. This instrument controls its pitch with a very long slide that gets extended out and then pulled back in. For example, let's hear Dave give us what we call a glissando. So you can see that when Dave extends the slide, the notes go lower. Now that has something to do with the construction of these instruments because, you know, when you take a tube, for example, and you make that tube longer, that makes the pitch go lower. When you make the tube go shorter, it makes the pitch go higher. So let's see the glissando one more time. And as Dave extends the tube, that makes the sound of the trombone go lower. And when he pulls it back in, the sound is gonna go higher. Listen one more time. There you go. It's a very good demonstration of how that works. Now, on this side of me, we have the French horn, which is an instrument actually that we met yesterday in the woodwind quintet. But now, like I said, it's part of the brass family, so it's in its proper place now. Now, we talked about the shape of the French horn. It's got lots of windy, curly cues, and we talked about if you were to stretch the French horn out, it would be about 17 feet long. It's a really long instrument. Now, Angela can control her pitch in some of the ways that, well, that Dave can, except you'll notice that her hand goes into the end of the French horn, which we call the bell, and that's where the sound comes out of the instrument, but she is able to stifle the sound and even change pitch with just using her hand in there. Listen to this. And maybe you couldn't exactly see it, but she just kind of squeezes the sound in there and then lets it back out, and you can see it changes the pitch of the French horn. Now, the French horns, I'll tell you this, they usually sit towards the back of the orchestra, and they have to have a really important job, and that is their sound actually goes backwards and then it goes forwards, so they have to be really on top of their music to play on time. Now, the instrument in the center that I want to introduce you to is Mr. Craig playing the trumpet, which hopefully you've seen the trumpet before. And the trumpet in the brass family, I'll say the trumpet is the most brilliant. How about we hear just a little bit of the trumpet? Yeah, when you have three and four trumpets playing together, imagine that sound. In fact, you know, the brass family, I would go ahead and call them the most powerful family in the whole orchestra in terms of sound. So today, the brass trio is going to demonstrate their sound in a piece by a composer named Poulenc. Can you guys all say Poulenc at home? Poulenc, good job. This piece is going to be the third movement of his sonata. Take a listen to this.